In this example, a stub AS, in this case 30308, might receive IP address space, say 12.20.249/24, from one of its providers, such as AT&T, which happens to own 12.0.0.0/8. Now in this case, AS30308 wants to be multi-homed. In other words, it wants to be reachable via two upstream internet service providers. In this diagram, the two internet service providers are AT&T and Verizon. To be reachable by both of these ISPs, AS30308 has to advertise its prefix, which it received from AT&T, via both AT&T and Verizon. The problem occurs when AT&T and Verizon want to advertise that prefix to the rest of the internet. Well, unfortunately, although AT&T might like to aggregate this prefix, as I previously described, it can't. If it did, Verizon would still be advertising the longer /24 via its upstream link. And because of longest prefix match, all of the traffic would then arrive via the Verizon link, regardless of what AS30308 wanted to have happen to that incoming traffic. As a result, both AT&T and Verizon must advertise the same /24 to the rest of the internet. This results in an explosion of /24s in the global internet routing table. You can imagine that if a lot of stub ASs wanted to be multi-homed, then suddenly we've got a lot more /24s in the global routing table than might otherwise exist without multi-homing.